Ashlesha Adhan Rao. Today we are discussing the subject Advanced Java Programming. The subject code is 22517. This subject belongs 70 marks for theory exam, 30 marks for progressive assessment and 25 marks for external examination. So the first topic of this subject is Abstract Windowing Toolkit for 12 marks. The first point of this topic is introduction. Java has been around in industry for quite some time. It has its roots deep in the programming world. For example, web applications, mobile applications, and embedded system, and so on. Even if we are talking about the graphical user interface, Java provides a rich set of library called AWP library, which allows us to create window-based applications and controls. So the AWP is Abstract Windowing Toolkit, which allows different types of web applications and graphical user interface program. So it is the first Java framework since the version 1.0. It contains different types of methods and classes which allows us to create window-based application and GUI. The AWT is platform dependent. That is, the component of AWT are the view of that component is depend on the that particular platform, that is operating system. So basically, what do you mean by component? Means, for example, if we are going to take one login application, in that login form, there are text boxes there and buttons are there. In text box, we are going to insert name and password, and the submit button is there. That buttons allow us to submit whatever the login credentials is there. So the button and text box, those are visual components, and those are called as AWT components. So the components of AWT are called platform dependent because it called its native subroutine to create that component. Means, for example, if I want to create one button using AWT, so the AWT directly calls the operating system and create that button. Means the native subroutines are going to call the button or creating the button. That's why it is called as heavyweight component. It is rarely used now because every time I am going to create a different component and every time my operating system is calling the native subroutine, this is quite heavy operation according to the operating system. So the components of that AWT are called heavyweight components. For example, if I want to instantiate in the text box, then actually my operating system is going to create that text box. These are the features of our AWT. So the package name where the classes are combined, the name of that package is java.awt. We should import that package before using all the components. So the next point is hierarchy of AWT. Let's see. The object, as we know, the object is the base class of all over the Java. So the main base class of AWT is component. Component is the top level of hierarchy of AWT. It is the abstract class which encapsulates all the attributes of visual components. Visual components means your button, text box, label, list and so on. Visual components which are directly interacted with the user, and we can see that components, those components called as visual components, and these visual components are encapsulated with the class component. Again, the next subclass of that component is container class. What do you mean by container? Container means it contains the other objects of the components. Means container can contain button, text box, label and so on. On that container we are going to laying out the components. So the container has two subclasses. One is window and second is panel. The window. Window is the base class. It is a base class of window which does not create object. If we want to create window, we should use the subclass of ray or dialog. You cannot directly create the window. It directly exists on the or sit on the desktop. The window has no menu bars and no borders. The windows can be created by using frame, dialog or panel for that matter. Next, the subclass of window is frame. The frame contains title bar and menu bar. The frame is subclass of window. It acts as one type of window. Again, dialog. The dialogs are comes with border and title bar. The one example of the dialog is we can say the pop-up menu is generated, pop-up option is generated. For example, successfully login successfully or saving successfully. That window is called as dialog. Again, here the next subclass of that container is panel. Panel is called as concrete class, and which is subclass for applet. Applet is the one where we can create graphical windows or graphical interaction by using AWP package. Applet is the subclass of that panel. So, in brief, today we learned some features of AWP. For example, it is the first framework of Java since version 1.0. Again, it is used to create window-based application and GUI. Then the most important feature is that it is platform dependent. Why it is called platform dependent? Because AWP called native subroutines to create components. Here components means button, text box, label and so on. So it is calling the subroutine of the operating system. So the nature of AWP becomes heavyweight. That's why it is rarely used for some time. Okay, then hierarchy of AWP. The main class of that AWP is component, and it has the container subclass. Again, container subclass has window and panel. Window has again frame and dialog. With the feature, window does not contain menu bars or borders, and we cannot create the object of window directly. We should use the subclass frame or dialog or panel. Again, frame contains menu bar and title bar, and dialog contains border and title bar. Again, panel is the concrete class which having subclass applet. So this is the brief introduction and some information about hierarchy of AWP.